will be a bridge for God's people, that you will bring the love and the mercy of God to his people, and you will stand in the gap, bringing all of our needs to the throne of the Heavenly Father. And as you do that over and over, it's going to reconfigure your own life. It's going to change you. Because your gift of ordination, yes, it happened yesterday, but it's going to be an ongoing, unfolding as you say yes to him day after day after day. You will become more and more and more configured to Jesus Christ, the priest. The oratory that you belong to is a great gift to our diocese in the touching. You and the oratory brothers bring a spirituality and a texture to the Christian life that we would be so much poorer if you were not here. The sacrifices that you bring, the dedication of your life, the family spirit that you have, you remind us that ultimately the church is a family. The family of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And you remind us the Christian life with each other, so much poorer each other. If you were not here.
And in our priesthood,
the Christian life and your brother is the same example to us if you were not here. And I would say sacrifices come to the family of the dedication of so absorbed in the spirit that you have, apostolic work, and among us, for God, that ultimately the church are connection to the family of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
So we need your oratory.
And you remind us the Christian life to remind us of how much we need us. If you were not here.
And in our priesthood,
Christian life and the brothers and sisters are ordained as our very gift to your oratory.
And I would say sacrifices
would also strengthen us to absorb the spirit that you have, apostolic work, and commend us for God, the gifts that you have, church, our connection.
Finally,
under the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit,
we need your glorified.
And we remind us the Christian life
there is so much we do.
The gospel
that sends in our priesthood,
Christian church gives us the house,
and we
the gospel
of your oratory,
and I would say to you,
but also
literally has an encounter
with the spirit that you have
had,
divine
knowledge and inspiration
of the church and
conventionally.
Finally, the
best of the word says that we are full of time,
and we are glorified.
And we remind us the Christian life
here is,
makes this
to gospel,
makes it sense
to our priesthood,
which is what Jesus
does,
and we are
done the gospel.
He makes that assessment
with Jesus is,
and we are
literally has an equal
time of the living God,
and we are
glorified. Christ,
the Son of the Holy
Jesus, for our
ship,
in such a way that Jesus was able to confess
the word of
says that we
are still
under the flesh and blood,
and we are
Christian
life
is
makes this
to gospel
and success
of the gospel
and the truth
of the gospel
and
the
truth of the gospel.
He
makes
that assessment
with the sense
that it's going to
be a
new
has an
end of
the
first of
the challenge
as a
friend of Christ
and our
courage and
justice for our
ships
and children.
In such a way that
Jesus
was able to confess
the word of
says that it's
going to be a new
has an end of the
first of the challenge
as a
Christian
life
and the
truth of the gospel
and the truth
of the gospel
and the truth
of
Yes,
the
true religion is
really
to do.
Distractions of your life.
grasp my
I'm going to go to the hospital. Yeah. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For thy kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, source and perfection of every virtue, grant, we pray, that by participation in this mystery, I may do what is right and preach what is true, so that by my deeds and by my words, I may offer to the faithful instruction in your grace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a moment. So it's good to see all of you and to be able to say on behalf of the oratory and on behalf of the Church of the Holy Trinity, welcome. Living as we are in this unprecedented time, it's a tremendous joy to finally be able to celebrate Fredy's priesthood with all of you who are here and all who are joining us by video. And it's an honor for this parish to host this Mass of Thanksgiving. To me, the word that captures Father Fredy's journey to the priesthood is perseverance, as Father Tim alluded to in his homily. Over 12 years, he's attended four schools, five if you count Miss Ruth's accent reduction classes. numerous times, he's had to change course. He's had extended interactions with our immigration system, and he's experienced other serious challenges, any of which could have caused him to abandon his vocational path, but he persevered. And in the process, he grew and matured and learned about himself and about the Lord in ways that have uniquely prepared him for priestly ministry. So, Father Fredy, we honor you, we congratulate you, we pray for a long and fruitful priesthood for you. We're counting on getting at least 40 years of good, hard work out of you now. So my advice to you is the advice that our Pope Emeritus, Benedict XVI, gave to the young people when he visited New York in 2008. And I was there, and this stuck with me. I quoted it at my first Mass. I want to offer this to you. Remember that what counts before the Lord is to dwell in his love and to make his love shine forth for others. And I know that that's your desire, and that's what you will do. So first and foremost, we have God to thank for making this celebration possible. But there have also been a lot of humans involved too, as you can tell, because we've never had this many people in the sanctuary before. So I want to take a moment to thank a few people in a particular way. I want to thank our music ministry, led by our friend, our new director of liturgy and music, Anthony Nardino. I see Alicia and Joe Gree up there, and Natalie on trumpet, and Edna, our psalmist today, all our music ministry, thank you. Our MC, Tom Phillips, from the bishop's office, who kept us pointed in the right direction. Of course, Father Tim, our vicar general, our homilist today, who's been, as you could tell by his homily, a great friend of our oratorian project and a particularly strong supporter of Father Fredy. So Father Tim, thank you. My brother oratorians, all the concelebrating priests from our diocese and beyond, our deacons, our readers, and anyone that I might not have included yet, thank you. After we conclude Mass, Father Fredy will be available to confer his first priestly blessing upon those who wish to receive it, especially those who didn't have a chance to receive it yesterday. And then we invite you to join us on the other side of the rectory for a pandemic restriction-friendly outdoor reception. with pizza and gelato from Ama Pizza in Hillsboro. And special thanks to them for helping to make this possible. Thanks also to those who helped us to set up outside with the tent and the beverages and everything else. I'm grateful to all of you who have helped us get this together. I ask that you remember, though, as we go forth from here and we go to the party, please remember that out of love and concern for each other, we need to do our best to take care of each other, so keeping appropriate distancing, face covering when possible, and hand hygiene. We'll bring some hand sanitizer out there too while we enjoy this time together. And the restrooms in the parish center, which is across the parking lot, will be available for your use. The building is open, so in the case that we get a pop-up thunderstorm or something, you can take shelter in the parish center. So God bless you all. Thank you all for celebrating with us today. And I'll invite now my brother oratorians to join me in front of the altar to receive Father Fredy's blessing.
Please don't let me cry, but it's not working, it's not working. I guess everybody who's here means a lot to me. Everybody who's seated in this pew, and I know there are many others who are outside of this church that are willing to be here without, well, for obvious reasons, they couldn't come and join us this beautiful day. I ask you to pray for me.
Every day you need your prayers. It is not the end.
As you, Father Tim said, it's just the beginning of a new
life, of a new
road. And I thank you for your love. I thank you for your support.
I thank you for your prayers. Please keep doing that.
I did it. I forgot something. So for the procession, for those who want the blessing, just stay there. We are gonna process out, because if not, they're gonna be just trapped here for
3 hours.
And they want their pizza right now. They're really hungry. So we are gonna process out, and then we're gonna come back. We're gonna take a couple of pictures with the auditorians. Then you can come for the blessing. Please go. This pizza, if you haven't, it's amazing. Yeah. We can celebrate with this beautiful mass with that pigs. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May your faithful people rejoice, we pray, O Lord, to be upheld by your right hand and progressing in the Christian life. May they delight in your good things, both now and in the time to come, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
To God.